U.S. Navy has been increasing its submarine production rates steadily over the past several years. They're about to hit a big boom in submarine production, going from 2 Virginia-class submarines a year to an even larger variant of the Virginia-class submarine plus the very large Columbia-class ballistic missile submarine. This is putting a huge strain on the submarine industrial base, who not only has to keep up with the increasing number of parts, but as well as create spare parts for the larger fleet of in-service submarines. Various segments of the industrial base are handling this pressure differently, but the Navy is really seeing a strain in the parts of the industrial base that handle metalwork, essentially, the castings, forgings, and fittings. These areas are very difficult to get new companies to want to come into the submarine industrial base because they take so much equipment, large cranes, large devices to heat metal to liquid, be able to pour them into large molds to create parts for submarines. And this is really where the submarine industrial base is seeing the most strain today as they look towards growing the number of new submarines as well as sustaining the in-service submarine fleet. The Navy has tried repeatedly to pour money into the industrial base to help shore up critical suppliers that can't keep up with increased demand. These efforts haven't worked in certain remaining critical infrastructure areas that are still considered to be fragile. So the Navy has decided that they're going to help these companies by introducing additive manufacturing. They're not going to take business away from the existing suppliers. However, the plan is to pair them with additive manufacturing experts throughout industry, such that the companies can kind of share their designs with 3D printing companies and come up with around-the-clock printing, essentially, to supplement what they're doing with metalworking. So the Navy would go out and work with these additive manufacturing small businesses and really just get that segment of the production ginned up by later this year is the plan, so that they can have more capacity for these metal pieces. The Navy has a list of their top 6 to 10 priorities for additive manufactured parts. These could be anything from shafts to pipes, so just blades. They're really looking at what makes the most sense to get started. The issue with additive manufacturing in the past is getting through a certification process. These pieces go on submarines, and the submarine community has very high safety standards for any component that would go on the submarine. So the Navy needs to work through that certification process between now and later this year. But the idea is to start with these simple parts that are done by suppliers that are struggling to keep up with the demand. And so you're really kind of getting the best of both worlds by learning this new technology as well as helping the weaker parts of the industrial base. The Navy expects to have its first 3D printed part on an in-service submarine by later this year. Essentially, that part would get put into the submarine during a maintenance period. If this goes well, we can expect to see more 3D printed parts added into the supply chain for submarine repair, as well as potentially the next submarine down the line, the SSN-X Next Generation Attack Sub, could even be designed to accommodate 3D printing if this process proves to be worth it. We'll be watching to see how this 3D printing effort continues throughout this year and into the coming years. For Defense News, this is Megan Eckstein.